Hey everyone, just a heads up again. We do these collaborations obviously because we enjoy them. We hope you guys do too. Sorry, there might be a few blips here and there just because sometimes their website hiccups while we're doing reactions or one of ours is freezing. So that's why we do our best to piece it together. So I apologize in advance.
What's poppin', everybody? How's everyone doing this evening? This is your boy Ivan, and with me is my boy Niche DFX. And today we're gonna be looking at the latest death battle, Yushin versus Mitsuru Kyoto, YC, Ruby versus Persona series. Now this is a very highly anticipated battle for both the Ruby and the Persona fans. And well, first and foremost, let me just say, if you guys didn't see our prediction video, we kind of, a lot of people were saying that we kind of underestimated Mitsuru. We weren't really underestimating her. I was just going based on the information I was reading at the time because we kind of have to rush through it a little bit. So I do apologize if, if you think we missed something or if we got something wrong, we do apologize for that. But that's what a prediction video is. We're not going to go through every single research. Just look at what we have and make a prediction from there. But now that that's out the way, Nidge, what is your thoughts about this battle before we get into this?
Yeah, the new information that was coming into us from some of you fans can change our minds, but at this point, what we decided is we're going to watch the pre-analysis and we're probably going to pause it and then make one more prediction just in case to see if there's something, else that we can go off of. Because sometimes when people give us advice and we appreciate it, it can be out of context.
Yeah.
Stat feats and stats. So that's why we got to be careful too what we hear. Because anybody could come on our channel and be like, well, Mitsuru farted and blew up a planet. So it's like, I, you know, there, there, there was, there's no proof of any of it. I just take it as someone's word. But that's why we're hoping this pre-analysis is going to show us some of that stuff. So
Absolutely.
other than that, before we begin, you guys, please go ahead and watch the original full screen for Titan Blood Anime because Nij and Ivan, we do not shut up. Also, they are cool with the reactions. I think Ivan's got some fam over visiting him, unfortunately. We're trying to sneak this
No,
in, guys, so we really apologize, everybody. I hope you guys
no,
are
we're sorry about
loving
that.
that
I'm sorry.
cute little adorable squeak in the background. So
Yeah, sorry about that.
all right
But
then, should we get this started then? Because I'm pretty
let's get
sure
rolling.
we talked enough for this.
That's my monitor.
I can't hear any of yours.
Okay, good. I can hear perfectly.
Okay. Yeah, I think we're good with balancing and everything right now. So they got an
All right, sweet.
RTX event coming down. I definitely would love to go to that, but I would be
Absolutely.
so nervous going to that because I'm not saying we're popular in the death.
Yeah.
Okay, I can hear that now. Yours.
Okay, there. Okay.
All right, and you're probably about 3 seconds ahead of
Today,
me.
we're pitting together two queens of
Okay.
vice born into powerful, if troubled,
My
families.
waifu, Weiss.
Yushin,
She's so
heiress to this
beautiful.
knee dust company and member
I'm
of the Huntress Team
not gonna lie,
Ruby.
Mitsuru is hot.
And
She's
Mitsuru
beautiful.
Kirijo, heiress to the Kirijo Group
I
and
would take
member of
care
the
of her
Persona
Weiss as far as
wielding
looks go,
Scene.
but that's just me.
He's with
How could you?
well, she's
Sarsaki
more
and Mai
mature
for Ultimate's
looking.
armor and
Yeah, I
skills
know,
to
that's true.
find
She's
out
like
who
20 years old,
wins
so
a
naturally.
death battle.
I think she's like 24 or 5, I thought.
The
They'll
world of
probably show us here.
Remnant
Let's
is
just watch
known
it.
for many
Yeah.
things. The vicious
All right,
creatures
let's hear
called
about my
Grim,
girl.
the hunters and huntresses committed to fighting them,
I'm
and
sorry, I love
the
her.
human
Shakalaka.
family.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're kind of like royalty, and their princess is Weishni.
Full
As the
name Weishni,
heiress to
Weishni,
the
5E3.
family
She
company,
goes
she grew
heiress
up in a pretty
left-handed. Yes,
cold
I already knew
world.
that.
Pun intended.
Inspired by
The
Snow
Yushin
White, already
family
knew
explained
that.
a
And
lot.
nickname
I didn't
Ice
know that.
Queens.
It was considered
Yeah, she was
essential
left-handed. I've
due
always
to
known if
their
you watch,
highly
if you watch her,
influential
her
name.
rapier is always on
And
her
bad
left
for
hand.
them, she
No,
had
the
her
Snow
own
White
blood.
comment is why
Rejecting her
I
father's
didn't
wish to
Oh,
remain at
yeah,
home,
her name
Weiss left to
Weishni
attend Beacon
is
Academy
German for
and train to become a
White
huntress.
Snow.
Literally putting the W in Team Ruby. Within just a
I
year,
gotta
Weiss
elaborate
established
more
her
on the
own name for
details later.
There we
saving
go.
the kingdom on more than one
That's a
occasion,
speed blitz
and doing
right there.
so
We
with
didn't
her
even
trusty
consider.
blade,
Yeah,
Mirasmith.
true.
And that's
I
my
love
cue.
her
Bert
weapon.
Nasty
Yeah.
here is a
Two, three,
multi-action
six cloud
creature with a
dusts,
three-blade
fire, ice,
long
wind,
blade.
hard, light, lightning.
Guess
I
what?
love
It's
her weapon's
also
one of the
good.
coolest. I love her
Instead of
weapon.
plain old
Yeah.
Krasgard,
It's the
she's
most
definitely
realistic.
very
Rod
versatile
Revolver-style
creature.
chamber that Weiss
Exactly.
fills
It's
with
also like the
bullets
most
colored
realistic
like
weapon that
rainbow.
could really be made.
Well, they're not
Unlike the other
exactly
ones.
bullets. They are vials
I don't know.
of
I like
death,
Yang's
which she can
gauntlet.
fire to enhance her
The
weapon.
Yang's gauntlet is lit. I'm talking about like
Ruby, the
if you
Snee
were to build
Dust
them in real
Company,
life.
is by far
I
one
think
of the
YC
say the
largest
punch gauntlets would be
users and
realistic.
exporters of dust.
That'd be pretty tricky
Wait,
because, the recoil and, all that
got a ton
stuff,
of that
that's
junk
gonna have to
covering the
work.
bookshelf in my trailer. I can sell it and finally have enough money to buy a second
That's
bookshelf. Dust farm, here I come.
weird.
No, not that kind of dust. In the world of Remnant, dust is an energy source
Crack.
often used to fuel
Trey.
vehicles, androids, and weapons.
I get
Wait,
that
not
stuff.
books?
Multicolored
When
crack
did
as a
I say
weapon that
anything
can use
about
elemental
books?
powers.
Well, long story short,
Imagine
there are
that for a
four
minute.
main types of dust: air, lightning, fire, and water.
And Weiss likes to mix water and air together for her favorite.
ice dust.
And that is why
she still don't like it. Like, what? Like,
she can also attack with fire, launch a windstorm, block attacks with barriers, and many, many other techniques.
She's really got
needless
a...
to say,
she'll find out quick the immunity of the ice, you know?
She also uses dust to boost her that's a given.
Which is basically her X-Men superpower. Weiss gets hers from her family line and can do a bunch of stuff with it. She can make glyphs on surfaces or in the air, each glyphs, with a different color denoting its ability. Black glyphs hold things in place, while white ones propel things forward. Also, by infusing glyphs with dust, she can manipulate their effects. For example, a touch of lightning dust lets her...
Yeah, that's what I mentioned before. Glyphs, propulsion, gravity, time dilation, summon, Boratux.
Summon monsters to aid her in battle. Beastmaster
style. That time
dilation
is going to help her a lot.
Definitely.
She needs that to stay quick.
Which literally translates to giant armor in Latin, so fitting.
I'm pretty sure only the females in the family can use glyphs.
Yeah, this guy doesn't seem to be worth anything.
It's just a bratty little bitch. Yeah.
The Schnee family does suffer from some rocky relationships.
Yes, exactly.
Weiss and her older sister Winter.
Sanders. Oh shit! Yo, he kind of does look like. Oh shit! I can't believe I didn't see that. I can't really know what made that connection.
Yes,
he does look like her.
What? You don't carry Parker?
She can summon creatures that is no. Been slain, battle specifically those who have gathered importance over personal growth while her sister can summon,
It's powered by her aura.
Okay.
Like an invisible shield around her body. She's basically unkillable while it's up.
Yeah, we already knew that. Aura can break.
Yeah, right there. Once she goes in that lava, poof.
Yeah.
Damage and needs time to restore itself. Without it, she cannot
And once you use a semblance, they're like,
that really puts her at a disadvantage.
Armagigas, cut up a paladin, nearly toppled the Colossus, start the sound attack.
Celsius, enough to melt iron. And
there it is.
Food fight of all things, she was thrown into a pillar.
I forgot how hard that was.
Remember, she got knocked out by Nora. Hey, Wiz, that's what I said.
That's true. I forgot how hard she hit her, too. Like, that
one's tame by comparison. But greatest of all, with a combination of ice and her aura, she survived riding atop a speeding train crashing through concrete.
Ooh.
By measuring the diameter of the resulting hole and
here is a new
the
durability.
Of fragmentation,
but that's...
this means Weiss survived an impact equal to over 7 tons
of TNT. You gotta be careful with that, because that ice shield helped.
I
would give the shield the credit, not her the credit. You get what I'm saying?
I agree.
You gotta be careful how they're wording that.
Yeah, that's true.
This episode was dope.
200 metric tons of ice, but that's because she had water, right?
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, that much ice doesn't fit.
Yeah, exactly. What I just said.
She's likely using the ocean as a base to exert fusion.
Goddamn math. Or wait,
nitrogen in the air, thereby freezing it like so. At most, this would require over 900 billion joules of energy, equivalent to detonating around 230 tons of TNT.
Damn.
Wow! No wonder she could push that big old robot around. Plus, Weiss can also move super quick, dodging missiles, and even hit.
There's the missile dodge feat we talked about too.
Yeah, exactly. In the manga, Weiss has some greater feats such as using glyphs to pull meteors out of outer space, but these aren't canon. That would have been sick.
How are they not canon?
I don't know.
Please go to a doctor.
Throughout her canon. Maybe Weiss not continuity, but they're canon.
But her most difficult
I don't know, that's what their word is, but if she can do that shit, that's impressive as fuck. I would love to see that in the seasons coming up.
I remember that when her daddy took the card.
The ruby
nerfed
it. I love the intro of that, how they edited that. That was so beautiful. When they keep switching between each other right here. It's just amazing.
It is. Man, I'm nervous for her now. Like, my heart's racing. You can't see it, but I'm literally shaking. Kirito. Mitsuru Kirito. 5v5. Eris. Damn, they're so much alike. Like, they're literally, she's literally Weiss persona.
Yeah.
They're literally, aside from their abilities, like, they're virtually the same people.
They can come off that way.
Yeah, like, I could totally see a crossover with these two in the game. Like, you know, hey, you're just like me. They could be, you know, they're just so alike. This is one of the first few death battles where the two characters were super alike. That they can, you know,
which often appear as malevolent monsters. They're basically demons. Kind of. However,
okay, let's see what this chick can do.
Integrated with the minds of individual people.
Shadow selves. Personas.
There we go. There's our chance to understand this.
Yeah. Some of them are demons which I have no idea about, so sue me.
Well,
We got a lot of love for that shadow card. Especially me. Shadow? Faster than light, bitch! Whoops. Oh, you mean demon shadow. Got it.
Yeah, exactly. My light shadow.
Chaos incarnate erupted. The resulting explosion from his experiment released the shadows into reality to prey on an unsuspecting populace and unveiled the Tartarus, a citadel between worlds. The Earth was drastically changed with a new dark hour, an extra hour of time occurring at midnight.
Most folks didn't notice, though. The world basically freezes in time during the dark hour, including people. So nobody's got to pick up a new 25-hour clock, because when the hour runs up, everything continues like nothing happened.
Nice.
It's like getting an extra hour of secret sleep.
But some people are able to operate during this hour, including Mitsuru, which she decided to take full advantage of.
Yeah, she felt pretty guilty about her family basically ruining everything and sending hundreds of murder monsters into the world. So
just like Weiss and her family. Rapier, Persona, Armatia, sorry, I can't pronounce it. Retractable Ice Wave, grants immunity to ice, grants analytic and clairvoyant powers.
Read that in your head sometimes, you know.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Clairvoyant, so yeah, that's gonna help her.
Right on.
But this event also led to
I read these and I just have to read them out loud, like, naturally, so. But I'll read to myself. Alright, cool.
Her shadow self.
And that's how she became
AKA, not Stan.
Yeah,
I mean, they're virtually Stans, but obviously they're different, but, you know, like, when you see that, like, what's the first thing you think of? Stans.
The guy from Konami, that's who that is. Kirijou.
Exactly.
Ultimate form, Artemisia.
Artie is the best non-imaginary friend you could ask for. She's got all sorts of powerful
ice
spells.
Yeah, there we go. She can heal wounds.
She can heal Mitsuru's wounds. She can drain someone's energy and add it to Mitsuru's own.
So that's going to help her a lot.
And she can blow people up with mega deal of...
ignore special defenses.
While Artemisia cannot really be killed, she does have her limits. When a persona is
overtaxed
or takes damage, it becomes broken and unusable.
No, I didn't hear that, actually.
And since Artemisia
if the persona does not physically injure the user, rather
But this connection also grants Mitsuru her own set of special powers. She's physically superior to most others. She can also sense the locations of people and layouts of...
Yeah, there we go. Like I said, that's definitely going to counter for speed.
She's also immune to ice and the cold, so I'm not really sure why she needs that giant fur coat.
She rocks that fur coat.
Nice coat.
Mitsuru,
anyway,
yeah.
Mitsuru wasn't going into battle alone. She gathered a team of Persona users to form the Specialized Extracurricular Execution Squad.
They're like, I'm in it for the boobies.
Which is much
easier. Right on.
How can you say no to that?
Exactly. How do you say no to that?
While also scoring some extra credit because it was technically an after-school club.
Yeah, they are. If they're anything like this, I would be there. I would fucking live in Japan.
Mitsuru needed a tool to reliably summon personas with, and so came the Evoker.
Wait, what?
Might be a little disturbing to some people, so.
Oh boy.
Fair warning.
Yeah, it looks just like a gun, and that's
kind of the point.
She's
gonna kill herself to do it.
The idea is to use the gun to create an extremely traumatic experience, similar to how Mitsuru first evoked her own persona.
Wait, so with this gun, you shoot yourself, and you can bring your persona back.
Your face.
Yeah.
And pulling the trigger.
Okay, that's not you. If you told me that would happen, I would still not do it and just like wait a second for my shit to come back naturally.
I thought you wanted to join that club, Claire.
I would, but I the thing you would question like that.
And it was a goddamn cannon.
Oh, the horror, but also.
Oh, justice, please. 562 kilotons of ice.
Heck, another persona user is even fast enough to outrun a bullet fired.
Kronos, the god of time, she battled.
Have a muzzle velocity of 360 meters per second,
and personas can move even faster. Naoto's could react to and catch an arrow in milliseconds, and Mitsuru has defeated her in battle.
But hey, how about that time Mitsuru and her?
Okay, so naturally her persona can, you know,
totally wreck this whole bridge.
Body of bridge.
Damn. Okay.
Better than sex.
Better than sex.
Michael
you see
Bay.
That?
Yeah.
But Michael Bay. Shit, we're dead. Better than
interesting,
sex.
Interesting, but let's use some real science now.
This is
that's
real
funny.
Science. I tested explosions and their real effects on. Real
okay,
people,
I'm starting to.
Like
yeah, I think why screwed.
Well,
I'm just gonna.
Let's see. Let's see.
Wait, real people.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm
I still have to see the
Where
speed.
Are the interns?
That's. Uh-oh.
Yeah, well, it says her persona is fast enough to, like, you know, scale to the girl's arrow-catching shit, so that's definitely going to help. And also, her clairvoyance can also... Her clairvoyance is a thing as well.
By working with another persona user, Yukari, Mitsuru helped freeze up this giant, creepy puppet monster.
Well, yeah, but again, that's a team effort, though. That's what it sounded like right there.
Yeah, it is a team effort thing.
It's required fusion energy and vaporization energy to find this feat.
Jesus Christ, what's with this mass?
60 kilotons of TNT.
Though this can't bigger, all be Mega or Kilo? As she
did have megatons, bigger than kilos.
Okay. Sure make a powerful pair. She's also and immune to ice. Did they mention that yet? The
dark hour they've mentioned that. Name,
okay.
Mitsuru continued battling for people everywhere, one shadow at a time.
This appears to be just the beginning.
Well, do we want to pause it quick and talk about it, or?
Yeah, sure, let's just pause it. Yeah, I'm pretty sure Weiss is screwed at this point, because Mitsuru, like, she survived a half a nuke, her clairvoyance, and her natural persona speed can maybe counter even with the time dilation, and also, she has good, and the fact that she's immune to ice, which Weiss uses a lot, which
I don't think
Weiss stands a chance.
Okay. Yeah, so, I'm kind of on the fence about it. Yeah, she did take on Kronos, the god of time, so we have to give her really good credit for that. Like, that's pretty damn
absolutely.
Impressive.
Like, yeah, absolutely.
I didn't know about that. You were researching, and unfortunately you didn't find it. So that,
I didn't
definitely,
find...
that definitely puts it in perspective of a power scaling.
Who I think is going to win, I'm just going to go with Mitsuru, unfortunately, and I love Weiss to death, but I think Mitsuru is a little more powerful, but... We'll just see. I could be wrong, could be right. We'll just have to see. So, you want to break it down?
Got Weiss in your heart, but Mitsuru is probably going to win.
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough, man. I'm just going to root for Weiss still. But Mitsuru is definitely the hotter one. All right, let's do this. We'll break it down. You ready?
Let's go. Yeah.
It's time for death metal!
That's hitting herself in the head. It was so weird.
Nice. The team of Rooster Teeth definitely put this together.
Yeah,
they're
fighting in Salem's castle, and they're already starting the fight.
Such good form. You fight with a sense of ease. Thank you.
They're already starting the fight, like no buildup or anything. It's just right away.
Let's just get into it, you know?
Yeah.
I didn't even hear battle or any. Yeah, it's just.
They stopped doing that. Stopped doing that. Okay, here we go. She's gonna stop it.
That ain't gonna do anything to her.
Yeah, they ain't gonna do shit. Yeah, see?
Yeah. Talk to the hand. You know, take him through
a fighting with ice. Ironic. And a waste of time.
Oh, the sprites are beautiful. Yep. Like, this is really well done.
Oh! He's able to deflect it. That's impressive.
Yeah.
Oh, she's gonna get spanked!
There we go. Okay, what's happening?
Ice again? You're wasting your time, girl.
There we go, fire. There we go, fire. But she used it right away, so that just leads me to believe. Oh, there we go, her B.
Oh, yeah.
Ice queen. Yeah, that's what it's like. You should know already, wife.
I love the irony of that part.
I do.
There we go. Speed blitzer if you can, girl.
Oh, shit, that's hot.
Mm.
Oh.
That B is pretty tough, but is it tough enough? Tough.
Oh, kick to the head.
Oh! That Kabuki Joe. Oh!
Oh shit, her
nice.
Gravity. That's
get out of your
it.
Mish! She's like, get up.
There we go, the Armored Knight.
Just don't give him the Ice Blade, girl, whatever you do.
Yeah, just give her anything element. Else. Just...
Now it's our turn.
So, like, now they can. Now they're on equal terms.
Or at least more of a chance at this point.
Yeah, exactly.
Nice slide! That's hot. Dope. The choreography of this is just insane.
It is beautiful.
Watch out, girl!
Oh, goodbye.
The ultimate sacrifice.
As annoying as this was, I have to admit, you fought valiantly. But now, you'll fall by my own hand.
Damn.
I can do this on my own.
Oh shit, stop. Stop the video.
Oh, shit. There we go. Oh, see the time!
Her time dilation.
Did it work? Oh no!
Oh,
Nuka
no.
Bitch.
Oh, that's the.
Oh, her semblance is gone.
Oh,
she's
screwed
now.
No. She can't do her glyphs anymore. I think it's over.
Yep. How strong are you? Uh-oh.
The gun. Oh, she's gonna bring it back. Strong enough. It's a wrap. She lost.
Oh,
it's a wrap.
No.
Yeah, it's a wrap.
Nani?
Her aura is gone. She can't use her glyph
anymore.
Oh,
it's no! She's gonna take it down.
There it comes. No!
Oh.
Just finish her off. It's over. Hey, she didn't kill her.
They did. They just wouldn't show it.
Yeah.
Oh, Weiss got it.
That's horrible. Why? Let's hear it.
Weiss was incredibly skilled. Her versatility certainly proved a challenge for Mitsuru, and she held a decent advantage in speed thanks to time dilation. Though, to be fair, Mitsuru's analytical...
Granted, Weiss's movement and speed feats were relatively similar to stat building spells. Yeah, she also has her stats, her spells that boost her stats. Time,
so Artemisia must be capable of similar speeds.
I don't know. They didn't factor in the missile.
Dodge. Yeah, true.
That's way faster than an arrow.
Yes, but we
that's true.
Who can win the most matches overall, not just a couple times out of a thousand possibilities thanks to one good move.
So Weiss does have an instant kill move. She could kill her, like, immediately.
Mitsuru's defenses were just too strong. Like how she completely canceled Weiss's ice attack.
Ice. Yeah, we said that.
Yeah, that's useless.
Problem for Weiss, who has always been fairly reliant on ice techniques. She was forced to use dust, which she has less experience with.
Plus, Weiss and her summons have never dealt.
That's not necessarily true.
Oh, shit, we're
she does. She's done really. She has. She's shown a lot of skill with gravity dust and even fire dust. So I don't think. I don't fully agree with that.
And considering how far Mitsuru was from the center of it, she took a hit worth over 21 tons of TNT. Definitely higher than Weiss's 7-ton.
Well, Miko didn't intend to kill her, and yeah, whatever. I also said that there was a little note that she said she had a fire-resistant type of thing. So I guess so.
130 times more energy than Weiss when she attacked that mech.
But numbers aren't everything, right?
Sure, there's always a new way to look at things. For instance, Weiss's arsenal was limited by her aura and dust supply,
right.
While Mitsuru had no such constraint.
That's
her
true.
Powers.
Mm-hmm. I can't disagree
it
with that.
A long time to restore aura, and remember, when a persona gets broken,
Weiss has no counter to any Mitsuru's stat changes.
Which was extremely useful, as Artemisia could heal Mitsuru at any time, undoing whatever
progress. Well, this really kind of proves
made.
That Tifa would be Yang, then. I'm sorry.
I'm not that I 100% agree with.
He put up a good fight. Mitsuru's greater defense, raw power, and more reliable arsenal proved too much for the Huntress.
She had
I can't disagree with that. I'm
she had
blind.
Snow chance.
Snow chance.
Right. All right, here we go. Here we go now.
Hey, thanks for watching Death Battle.
I'm
don't
bummed.
Go away just yet. We're about
I am.
To
I'm disappointed, but I can't disagree with that. But I'll explain when I'm finished.
Yep. Right there. There we go.
All right, who's next? Yeah, shut up. Who's next? Killing off my girl.
Oh, Captain Falcon.
Captain
Johnny Cage.
Falcon? Johnny Cage.
No.
Okay.
No.
Oh.
No.
Okay. I'll take this one.
God, please no. Captain
okay,
Falcon
let's talk.
No.
Okay.
Oh Lord. Lord of mercy. What the hell? That's hilarious.
That is funny. Okay, so let me get my thing out the way. I'm bummed, but a lot of the stuff they made sense. Yeah, she had limited dust. Her aura can't break. It does take a while to charge.
Mm-hmm.
And most of the, like, I'm bummed, but most of the stuff they said makes sense. But I'm still, but the fact still remains that Weiss is not at her full potential yet. Mm-hmm. So with the coming volumes, she may do something, that could potentially change the outcome, in my opinion. And I think that argument still stands because she's not had her strongest. Well, Mitsuru is at her strongest because they're not going to continue. They're already finished with the Persona 3 series, like someone told me.
Mm-hmm.
But
yeah,
a lot of
agree with you.
Yeah, I can't disagree with this, and I'm bummed that Weiss lost, but like I can't disagree with it. Like I can't call bullshit. I just think it's a little unfair because she's not her strongest yet. But overall, you know, it is what it is. It was still a great fight. It was still greatly animated, and you know, it was all well put together.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Yeah, she had snow chance in hell.
She has no chance in hell, yeah.
Snow chance. Yeah, no, they definitely clarified a lot of the stuff in the end, what we were talking about. And to me, though, I still feel that they underestimated Weiss's speed. That's just the only criticism I'm going to say. The fact that she can dodge missiles is way more impressive than someone catching an arrow. I'm sorry.
I agree.
I agree.
Like
I even calculated that the missile would fly around almost 5,000 miles per hour. So,
no.
But, They did mention there too that there's lightning dodging feats on both sides.
Yeah, that's true. And also,
they did bring that up. So they use just the arrow? That's kind of weak sauce compared to dodging lightning. They could have shown lightning for both of them at that point.
I'm guessing that's lowballing. Mm-hmm. But also, like they said before, that they said Weiss only is mostly reliant on her ice, and that she has less experience with her dust. I don't agree with that. Like she showed a lot of proficiency with gravity and even fire and even her time dilation. That's not weak. I mean, that's not, you know, that's skill.
She doesn't lack in it. She just prefers one over the other.
Exactly.
The way they said that to me, that made no sense. That she has lack of experience. No, she doesn't.
She does.
If she had lack of experience in it, then she would never carry it with her. She would have the revolver be pure ice then. She would ditch fire and all, you know, like, she to me is more like Batman. Just because Batman always uses his batarangs all the time doesn't mean he's less experienced in his grappling hook to swing around, or, you know, insert whatever argument there for Batman's case. You know what I mean? It's like a belt tool. So to say that, I don't agree with that. The speed feat, again, if both of them did the lightning, then I guess the speed was equal. I honestly thought Weiss had a better chance. I was hoping they were at least going to calculate her. Remember when she was speed blitzing through all those people?
I felt like they should have done that.
Because that at least could have showed that she would have been a lot faster. To me, she would have been able to dodge a lot more.
And travel.
You know, it is what it is.
And travel and in combat speed, because that was legitimate combat speed that she was doing. And keep in mind, they said she had time dilation. She could have literally insta-kill, you know, Masudo. But I understand what they meant. Like,
they said something like she countered it, the time dilation. They had a little sticky note that said that.
Yeah, because of her clairvoyance. Her clairvoyance and all that type of shit. So
to know where people are at? Is that their excuse? Because, I mean, knowing where someone's at still doesn't nullify...
That would be like saying she
would know where the Flash is using the Speed Force. And I highly doubt that. I'm pretty sure Flash or Superman would speed blitz the hell out of her. So, like, I don't understand their justification on it, honestly. I mean, I'm not mad. I mean, like I said, I love Ruby. And I only played the first Persona. So I have no connection to Mitsuru. And I'm not butthurt about the outcome. I just, there's just some a little bit of questioning. I guess if someone could clarify what we said in the comments below, we'd be glad to hear it, just so I kind of can just understand it more. And if I do rebut what you're saying, it's not because I'm trying to sound right. I'm just trying to make sure I understand it completely and explain my side at the same time to be changed. So just for the record, everybody in the comments.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. And that's pretty much all I have to say. Like, I'm not butthurt. I'm just bummed. But a lot of stuff that did make sense. But there's just stuff that we talked about this before. They kind of word stuff a little funny that just doesn't make sense. Like we just said, you know, her speed glyph. Even though she has her clairvoyance, you know, even if you could sense it coming, you know, you still have to be fast enough to react to it. And probably she is, but why does it show she can probably, you know, almost match her clairvoyance, in my opinion.
She can speed blitz Ruby, and Ruby is one of the fastest people.
Exactly.
She has caught Ruby off guard, and Ruby's semblance is speed.
Exactly.
That's the argument. Like, I don't know how you justify it.
Yeah, exactly. So even if she could see her coming, would she be fast enough to, you know, avoid every single thing she could throw at her? You know, I know it's animation, but she just showed that she necessarily can. Like, she can still get and take a hit from her, but at the end of the day, it is what it is, so I'm bummed.
And the armor would run out. Like I said, Nora literally one-shotted Weiss.
Yeah, like, that makes sense.
And she did. Remember, I said that before. I'm like, if she falls in lava, she's done. She instantly is wiped and everything. So I was like, she's really just a glass cannon. You know, she can put out some damage, but if she gets smacked really good once, she's pretty much toast. I was counting on her speed to carry her, but when someone's probably going to, you know, explain it to us in full detail, and then that's going to be a wrap then. Yeah, once the speed was let down, then she was pretty much done.
Okay, so do you want to quickly talk about the next step battle, just quickly?
Yeah, absolutely. Impulsively, who do you think between the two?
Johnny Cage. No, not Johnny Cage. Captain Falcon. I never played F-Zero, but I'm telling you, he's pretty fucking strong. I don't think Johnny Cage is going to beat him. Because keep in mind, this man drives race cars that go at hypersonic speeds, and to have the reaction time for that is pretty amazing. I know that's just one thing, but he's physically powerful. And I don't know. I just know
they're definitely going to put Smash Brothers into or Smash Bros. Whatever. And they're going to say, like, well, the fact that he could fight Sonic, I don't know how they're going to scale a video game because that's game mechanics.
Yeah, that's true.
Because Mortal Kombat is a game mechanic too, but that's where Johnny Cage is from. So it's like you have to use the game mechanics to Falcon Punch. I don't know if they're going to use the when he punches the punching bag, how far he can throw the sandbag Falcon Punch. Anime of Captain Falcon.
Yeah,
they're probably going to dig into that, so we're going to have to really see what they come up with. But remember, they do acknowledge Mortal Kombat's Test Your Might as a strength feat, because remember Sub-Zero versus Glacius. When he did the freaking karate chop, what's the strongest thing? There's a diamond in that game or whatever. Yeah. And they said, well, so minimally his strength's already going to be at that level. So if you think Captain Falcon can break diamond, I don't know. We're going to have to do our research, everybody, and get back to you. We will make a prediction for this. And hopefully we have fun doing it. If that sounds like you're going to take Captain Falcon, I'll do Johnny Cage then.
Yeah, we'll do. So I'll research a little Captain Falcon, you do Cage. So I think we should just wrap this up, shall we?
Absolutely, everybody.
Well, guys, if you guys enjoyed this reaction, please let us know in the comment section down below. We're going to have a playlist right here, a place to the left, a place to the right, a little shit to get your feet wet. And if you come and see, y'all go find us out there. Believe it. My name's Ive Animal. This is my boy, Niche DFX. And we'll see you guys in the next video.
We're out.
Peace.